Good afternoon, everybody. We're having another leisurely day because someone's sick.
I like woke up today full throttle sick.
Full throttle sick.
Full throttle sick.
So,
and so I'm in my pajamas.
She's in her pajamas. And her glasses that are full on plastic because she's blind as a bat. She's got 6 eyeballs, 3 lenses, astigmatisms, everything you could think of she's got. But I think Ben's gonna meet up with us in a little bit, but we're at Disney Springs this evening, just having another relaxing evening, just strolling, walking around, looking at all the shops, looking for deals, maybe see some Halloween stuff, who knows.
Flip-flops for Peter.
Oh yeah, we got some flip-flops because Eve destroyed mine, and the ones I have now are good for their cheap Old Navy ones. They were okay in Chicago, but they don't do good at all when they're even the slightest bit wet, which includes sweat. So they're probably like the worst thing you could wear ever in Florida. And I wear them every day when I get off work.
Also, we're gonna get 3 Ghirardelli.
Oh yes, that's the goal today. We're gonna get 3 sets of Ghirardelli chocolate. Why? Because this is just what you needed. So this is just what you needed. I love more than all the additional stores and new like designs of Disney Springs. I love all the extra, the live entertainment and everything. So much fun. Oh, thank you so much. Ghirardelli number 1. Time to go rock out.
Oh, I can't hear you, Disney Springs. You guys having a good time? That's what I like to hear.
She may be sick, everybody, but she knows her downtown Disney.
Sharp as a tack.
I was convinced there was no Tommy Bahama. But guess what?
I got a good memory.
Okay, if I need anything in my life, it is this velvety smooth. Oh, Sips Ahoy. I'm perpetually, ever since I turned like 18, I'm actually like 45 on the inside. I need everything inside the Tommy Bahama store. Okay, we found a pair of flip-flops for me. But we're not at Tommy Bahama.
No.
Tommy Bahama Jr.
I'm sweating.
You're nervous, that's why. Sometimes we get nervous when we shop. We're at Sperry and we found a pair of flip-flops and they got a deal for 2 for certain kinds. We don't know if Sarah's gonna get a pair of shoes or if I'm gonna get these like boat shoes that I think my feet are too wide for these kind of shoes, but I've always wanted them. Go figure. So we're seeing. I said maybe if Sarah finds a better shoe that she would enjoy more than me possibly not liking a boat shoe, then maybe she gets a second pair. But I got a pair of flip-flops and that the customer over there promised me they'd last more than 3 months and that her dad wears them and he's as big as I am. This is the 3rd pair of shoes that Sarah's trying to find in her size.
I'm just too average.
No, you're not average at all.
Wait. Oh, you're wearing clothes?
Yeah. They look good. Did you just get new shoes?
I did! My shoes were $80.
Her shoes were $80 and we got both
pairs,
and here are my Sperry flip-flops, and I'm a man who's got hobbit feet. Look at that hobbit foot. And I need,
you will keep those far away from our chewy puppy.
Yes, I'll keep them far away from you, but I need, and I mean need, big sturdy heavy flip-flops. If it was legal and allowed to walk around the world barefoot, work, Disney, everywhere, on the fire, I would go barefoot. But you gotta have at least flip-flops on. I think that's the real reason why we moved here. Not for Disney, not for the weather. We moved here so I could wear flip-flops 24/7. But the pair I bought before that Eve chewed up were actually like a temporary pair anyway. They were like, yeah, $10. So I'm really glad that we got these really nice heavy sturdy ones that
are gonna last.
Last time I got these are Sperry's. Last time they were Margaritaville, and the Margaritaville pair I think I wore for like three years I think, and they were shreds when I finally threw them away. But they were heavy, like I could knock somebody out with them. But I hope they're just as sturdy. The woman said they were very good. They were a very good pair. But now it's nighttime. It's always
and
weird
I got
how.
Boat shoes
instead, I got boat shoes. I'm gonna get boat shoes closer to my birthday or Christmas because I have extremely wide feet, and normal Sperry shoes like aren't that wide, and so I want to get like a really nice pair of like leathery Sperry ones that look wider.
Ben will be here in a half hour.
Ben's gonna be here in a half hour. We're thirsty. We're going to Starbucks to get water and maybe a tea. I am. Something's wrong with me. And then the cast member had a Harry Potter button. I said, where'd you get that Peter Pan button? Why are you nervous? You look like shaking.
I'm not shaking.
Oh, look like you were.
She's just struggling with
this.
Yeah.
No, this is just regular.
What's that place called again? Lillian & Co?
Lillian & Co.
Ooh, I forgot it was gold. Thank you, Matt.
Thank you. Yay. All right, woo. Are you gonna put it on her or is she gonna put it on?
She's gonna put
it
on. I'll break it or something.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna
do.
There we go.
Woo!
Thank you, Matt. You guys all the different types
of. Gotta get that jaw freeze fix. If you didn't catch on by now, by our tweets, by all of our posts, I am obsessed with Joffrey's. It is my favorite coffee of all time. Better than Starbucks, Dunkin' Donuts. There's a tea and coffee exchange in Boys Town in Chicago that has good coffee. I like Joffrey's more. So here is the wonderful progression on Edison. Opening late 2017, but I want it open now. I am a big history guy. I'm a big electrical engineering guy. And I love the whole theming of this. It looks amazing. And there are lights on. There are lights on in there. They're doing construction. And I think we have Ben with us.
Bye, Ben.
He just visited Matt in Chicago, so he's back to hang out with us. I think, is it over here you were saying, Ben? Is that what it is? Because that's what other people are saying.
Oh, no, it's gonna be to the right.
So we're talking about how there's supposed to be like a speakeasy style lounge in the Edison restaurant. Look at those windows. Oh my gosh. Look at, we're in Kate Spade. And look at this little mouse welcoming. It's perfect for your headband. Look at this cute bag set. We might have to get Sarah for Christmas this little purse bag. It's got an over the shoulder in there. Be perfect for the parks. You can put your cell phone in there.
Yeah, no, that's the perfect size.
Cell phone and a little bottle of water. And your deodorant.
And my dog.
And your what?
My dog.
Eva's not that small.
She could go in here.
She could go in there for sure. She wouldn't be happy about it, but she could. That's where the money's at. You can carry the backpack if once we get that. Thank you, Angela. It's not a trip to Disney Springs without some Ghirardelli.
Yeah.
Ghirardelli number two. I do not know. I don't know. You got.
I got his.
You got Ben's? I don't know if we're gonna get a third one because it's closer to close.
Oh.
And she might be out still later.
Yeah.
I've learned that headquarters are good for people who don't have.
Starbucks?
No, you didn't do it.
Amaretto's?
Ghirardelli?
Ghirardelli. No, Sarah doesn't know. Oh, wait, no.
I'll hook it up with the free water?
Yes. But Ghirardelli is not the coldest water. No. It's just like a little fountain.
So that was our tip, is like get Starbucks one with a lot of ice, and then once you're done, go to Ghirardelli.
Yes. And then Amaretto was just really nice. I saw that they had a jug behind the desk. We were talking to the cast members there about just like the offerings they have. They have like a wine slushy that Ben and Matt might go get while Matt's visiting. We might go with them. But we were talking about the different selections of pastries and drinks they have there. And then I was like, I saw the water. I was like, hey, can I have a couple cups of that water? Oh, sure. So thank you, cast member Taylor. Let me try to get the spring after he does. So fun fact. We've walked past this spring four times tonight, and I know I'm a grown man, but I like to have fun sometimes. And yeah, just sometimes. All four times we walked past this, somebody has come up and literally like ran, as you just saw, into it to try to get the spring water to go before I could. Can we wait?
We'll be back.
We didn't count, but it was probably on some kind of measure of like 9 kids. It was like a little kid runs up and wants to spin the spring to make the water come out. That kid's done, walks away. And before that child walks away, another child runs up and is like literally grabs the wheel before the first child is done. And it was like a movie that happened like 9 times in a row.
A little kid even said to Peter, you can go.
But I was like, I'm a grown man, like a little boy can go. He's gonna have fun, he's in Disney World. So I let him go. So, I mean, I guess to a point it's my fault. But come on, little kid's gotta go have fun first. But I think it was a sick joke. Like, I think they were planning it, like taking turns, like, all right, he's almost done, now you go. Oh wait.
There was nobody there.
There was literally nobody there when we walked up. So we left because Sarah's gotta go to the washroom and it's late.
And it's fun to be by a screen with the water noises when you have to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, it was kind of torture for Sarah. Sarah is getting ready for bed. We almost forgot to sign off, which is, we've been really good because during Vlogmas on our other channel last November and December, we forgot to sign off like all the time. I think we've been doing pretty well this with this new channel. We are going to Magic Kingdom tomorrow night to have fun and also to work because we need to take some promotional photos. I almost knocked over our fridge just now. We're gonna take some promotional photos for our button subscription business, plaincrazybuttonclub.com. So we'll have that tomorrow night. And it's been a whole month since we got to Florida. We started our vlog just a month ago from yesterday. So don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if you like to watch our fun little antics, if you'd like. And leave a comment down below if you have seen all of our vlogs or if you followed along with us during all these fun little adventures that we've been going on. Thank you, and it's good to be home.
We know what our goals are. We know what we hope to accomplish. And believe me, it's the most exciting and challenging assignment we've ever tackled at Walt Disney Productions.